Hey, this is Chris at Talon Gaming. Today we're going to be looking at a bit of a modern classic. Originally released in 2014, This War of Mine, an indie title by 11-Bit Studios. This War of Mine is a single-player survival strategy side-scroller, where you play as not a soldier, but a citizen in the midst of a modern, war-torn city. The complete edition of the game I'll be looking at includes the Anniversary Edition updates, which includes updated graphics, new characters, locations, and endings. It also includes the Little Ones DLC, which explores wartime survival through the eyes of a child, as well as the story season pass that includes three new story-driven scenarios. We'll take a look at all of the available DLC in a future video, so keep an eye out for that. The final cut version of the included base game also adds another scenario, new locations from the story's expansion, quests, events, and other extras. PC system requirements are really light. Most any dual-core CPU running Windows 7 or newer and 4GB RAM will suffice. Each game starts with a randomized scenario that includes 1 to 4 dwellers out of more than a dozen available characters, each with his or her own unique characteristics. Some can cook with less waste, some can steal without remorse, while others can carry more items. The game features a charcoal pencil sketch appearance, a predominantly black and white environment with an artistic feeling throughout. To keep your dwellers alive, you'll have to do your best to gather supplies by scavenging, looting, or stealing from others, while sifting through rubble, picking locks, breaking doors, searching drawers, and sneaking about. Crafting items and upgrading facilities is a big part of This War of Mine. You'll be building and upgrading items such as tools, weapons and ammunition, workbenches, heaters, stoves, beds, and more. You'll also distill alcohol, grow plants, trap animals, cook meals, and roll cigarettes. A mainstay source of supplies is the occasional trader who comes knocking. Pay attention to what their reactions are to each item and figure out what they're willing to part with for cheap or willing to pay handsomely for. Occasionally, neighbors will stop by asking for food or medicine, offering up supplies, or asking for some assistance, and occasionally a place to stay. To keep your dwellers alive, you'll need to manage their every need and want, including sickness, wounds, depression, happiness, sleep, and hunger. And it can be quite an intricate balance at times. At some point in the game, you'll likely run into a situation where avoiding a fight just is impossible. You'll need to defend yourself using knives, tools, and firearms. You don't want to die in this one, as there are no second chances. The radio is a main source of information and the current situation outside your dwelling. You'll find information about the war, about crime, hints on commodity values, as well as music. At the end of each day, you'll be forced to make some decisions. You can head out to scavenge for goods and materials, stand guard against looters and bandits, or catch up on some much-needed rest. Textures and animations aren't bad at all for what the game is intended to be. The game has crisp and clear presentation, without any frills. The low-key graphics and predominantly black and white, charcoal-filled world help to showcase the somber atmosphere of life in a war-torn nation. While sound effects are nothing to write home about, they don't feel out of place and do convey the actions of the game well, even if there is a limited palette of sounds. I will say that the atmospheric noise of explosions and combat in the distance is very good and does help to thicken up the context of the game. Music is also pretty good. It's quiet and relaxing, helping along with the subdued graphics to further set the mood the game is offering up. The story here isn't particularly deep, but it is very interesting. The game gives little to start with and lets you learn bits and pieces of information here and there. You will get a bit of story from the radio, a few nice additions from passersby, and from the many locations you visit. So while the story isn't all-encompassing, it is gripping, and you do slowly build up an emotional attachment with your characters over time, while also learning how they react to events, actions, and turmoil throughout the game. The controls are a very simple point and click, and that's it. This makes the interface extremely easy to navigate. That being said, learning when certain items can be used and in what manner is much more challenging. You'll need to learn to manage your character's needs both physically and mentally. It's quite a fun game with a lot more going on than what you see at first glance, and that's part of what makes the game so enjoyable. Expect the base game to take between 5 and 10 hours to complete, with the 4 DLC adding another potential 15 to 20 hours. There's some replayability here as well. The game length can vary from 20 to 50 days, there's quite a few characters to play as, different scenarios to explore, and the option to fully customize the difficulty of winter, the length of the game, and other parameters. Additionally, the game offers modding capabilities complete with Steam Workshop integration, so you can create or download mods to further customize the game, which again adds further value to the title. I think this unique take on war from a totally different perspective is something worth exploring. For anyone looking to try something new or a little different from anything they've played before, this game gets my vote. Give it a buy while it's on sale, and it's an absolute steal. As always, thanks for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, and consider subscribing for more content just like this. This is Chris from Talent Gaming, signing out.